This is the most hated topic in anatomy ever, the abdominal blood supply. But don't worry, this is animated anatomy and we're going to make it simple for you. This here is the superior mesenteric artery, and this here is the inferior mesenteric artery. Now let's start by explaining the superior one. And we're not going to follow the arteries, we're going to follow the digestive tract here, and we're going to actually explain where each part gets its blood from. So let's bring our digestive tract, and we cannot see much, can we? That's why I will remove the jejunum, and I'm going to remove the ileum as well. I will remove this part of the colon and stomach, so we can see the superior mesenteric artery hiding right here. Now the superior mesenteric artery gives away immediately one branch here, and that is the inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery, the anterior one and the posterior one as well. It gives blood to both of these arteries. Now you can see this little artery here, and that is the middle colic artery. But I said that we're not going to do that. We're going to follow digestive tract, and we're going to explain each part and where it gets its blood from, and we're going to come to that part. So this over here is the set of jejunal arteries, and down there you have the set of ileal arteries. Then you have here the marginal artery of colon. You can see how long it goes. And you know what? Let's just remove the testicular arteries because they're making this more complicated, and this is, by the way, already too complicated. Let's remove the lumbar arteries as well. Now it all looks a little bit more simple, right? We have the superior mesenteric artery, then the jejunal arteries, then the ileal arteries, then the marginal artery of colon, and then we have this artery here. It's the ileocolic artery, and it has the superior branch of ileocolic artery and the ileal branch of the ileocolic artery. Now we get to this part here, and that is the right colic artery. And then we get to this little buddy here, and that is the middle colic artery. So remember, we had the right colic artery and then the middle colic artery. So now let's explain this second really important artery, and that is the inferior mesenteric artery. The inferior mesenteric artery has here the left colic artery, and remember we talked about the middle colic artery and the right colic artery. Furthermore, the inferior mesenteric artery separates here into sigmoid artery and the superior rectal artery. So you have here the superior rectal artery, and this is the sigmoid artery. I'd like to point out that this part right here is not modeled exactly, and our inferior mesenteric artery is not supposed to go through the external iliac artery. That's just not correct, but doesn't matter. Furthermore, I wouldn't say that our aorta is so huge. It's a little bit smaller artery, though it's still very big.